Welcome to Her Remarkable History. Remember, to support our channel, please subscribe. The horrific afterlife of Barbara Radziwill, Queen of Poland. Much is known about many of the most famous English queens in history, for example, Elizabeth I. She's well known for her defeat of the Spanish Armada, and also the fact she had a long reign in which there was a golden age. Elizabeth is also remembered for her execution of Mary Queen of Scots. However, during the 1500s, there were many amazing stories of influential women who ruled and were part of other European monarchies. Barbara Radziwill was born in early December of 1520, and she had a very interesting life. Her father was the Vivode of Trakia and Vilnius, and her mother was also very high status. Little is known about her education, and it's assumed that she wasn't well educated. However, she could speak and write in Polish. She was noted for her beautiful looks and her charm, and she had a deep interest in fashion and cosmetics, often using makeup like most high-status women in the 16th century. She was offered to marry Stanislovas Kostaustas, a high-ranking member of the Lithuanian nobility, and a wedding treaty was drawn up. The pair married on the 18th of May 1537, with Barbara being around 16, and her dowry included many riches, including silver crockery, 2 dozen horses, and clothes of satin and damask, decorated with gold and precious stones. Their marriage did not produce any children. However, after around 5 years, tragedy struck with Barbara's husband dying of a short illness. However, Barbara, within 6 months, began to have an affair with Sigismund Augustus, the future King of Poland and Grand Duke of Lithuania. It's assumed that the two began an affair in 1543. However, Sigismund was married to Elizabeth of Austria. They travelled to Vilnius, where Barbara resided with her mother, in the June of 1544, but the following year, Sigismund's wife Elizabeth died from seizures. Following this, Prince of Poland and Barbara began to freely enjoy each other's company. Much rumours emerged at the royal court, as they would attend parties together and would go hunting. It was also believed that the prince created a secret tunnel, joining his royal palace to Barbara's palace, so the couple could meet secretly. There were calls for the prince to marry another woman, and other women who were high status across Europe and the world to secure alliances. However, it was clear Sigismund and Barbara were in love, and they married in secret in the year 1547. Their wedding most probably occurred between the 26th of July and the 6th of August, and it's believed the wedding was kept secret, as Barbara may have been pregnant. However, she allegedly had a miscarriage, and later Sigismund Augustus informed his parents, the King and Queen of Poland, of the marriage. The news of the secret nuptials caused chaos, and he had married without the approval of the Senate, and many prominent members of the nobility regarded Barbara as nothing more than a lover. Many even accused her of being a witch, who used poison and spells to seduce Sigismund and trap him. But when Sigismund's father died, he assumed the throne of Poland, but there was much debate about whether Barbara should become queen or not, and there were calls for the king to abandon his wife. However, Sigismund stuck by Barbara. They entered Krakow and Barbara lived a luxurious life. She was given large amounts of land and also royal residences, but she was not very interested in politics. Barbara's cousin and brother worked together to secure the family's power, and they tried to get Barbara to be recognised as the Queen of Poland. They worked with her husband, the King, to do this, and Sigismund insisted that she should become Queen. Barbara was crowned Queen of Poland on the 7th of December 1550, in a controversial move. However, her reign would not be a long and prosperous one. Since she had married Sigismund, she was suffering with her health. She often complained of ill health, which affected her stomach, and she spoke of internal stones, as in gallstones. However, following her condition, her health went downhill, and she had a fever, lost her appetite, and her stomach pain became much more severe. On her stomach, a lump appeared, which became full of pus, and the King of Poland was intensely worried by this. He saw his new queen go downhill, and he asked women healers to tend to Barbara. However, although she did pick up, this was brief and did not last for long. As time went on, though, things went downhill quickly. The king himself tended to his sick wife, and she allegedly stank of pus and suffered with fever, diarrhea, and nausea. On the 8th of May 1551 in Krakow, the expected came, and Barbara, the Queen of Poland, passed away in her bed. She asked to be buried in Vilnius, and her body was taken to the cathedral, and she was buried next to Sigismund's first wife. The king was devastated by her death, and he was distraught, and even walked a large amount of the journey to the cathedral on foot. Following her death, he wore black and avoided parties, and had a more serious outlook on life. The cause of Barbara's death has been disputed, as modern historians put it down to ovarian or cervical cancer, but at the time ambassadors gossiped about syphilis and sexually transmitted conditions. However, this wasn't the end of the story of Barbara, the Queen of Poland, as her remains emerged in the 20th century. Following a flood that greatly affected the structures of Vilnius Cathedral in 1931, the body and remains of Barbara were discovered. Now, during her final trip after her death from Krakow to Vilnius, her body had been covered in a substance to help preserve her remains during the long and hot summer days. Her body had been covered in a mix of ash and burnt lime, which helped to protect her remains. The wooden coffin she had been placed in had, over the 400 years, rotted away, but the lime hardened and formed a protective shell that preserved her bones and remained rather well. This shocked those who discovered her remains, and she was buried with regal ornaments, including a silver gilded crown, silver scepter, golden orb with a cross, and many pieces of jewellery given to her by her husband. These were remarkably preserved. However, during World War II, they disappeared. Now, during the Second World War, Vilnius itself was captured by the Nazis, who established two ghettos for the large Jewish population. As they were keen on stealing wealth and art, it's possible that some of Barbara's jewellery and artefacts may have been stolen and looted by the Nazis. When her skeleton was discovered, it was then subject to a number of checks and bizarre repairs. Her skeleton was cleaned and conserved, and also then glued together by professors at a nearby university. From this, they worked out that she was 5'3", above average for a woman at the time, and that she had white and straight teeth, a slim body, and a narrow face. It was noted that she also had a number of strange abnormalities. She had an extra rib, and also signs of rickets, but her remains then had to be hidden away again because of the Second World War, and they were taken to a crypt under the chapel of St. Kashmir, and were not touched until 2001. More work on her remains continued, where her height was recalculated to 4'4", and then using her remains, experts reconstructed her facial features in an attempt to show what she would have looked like. So Barbara Radziwill's remains were subject to a significant amount of tampering and experimentation, and also possible looting. However, her life and death inspired many paintings and legends, and many have regarded her relationship with the prince and king as a great love story. Thank you for watching, and to support, please subscribe to Her Remarkable History. Thank you.